بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه. إخوتي في الله، نحن بارك الله فيكم في دروس التفسير. We these days were in classes, lessons pertaining to تفسير القرآن, the explanation of the Quran. ولكن أنا أريدكم أن تعرف أن تعرفوا. I want you all to recognize and to be aware that there's certain علوم, هناك بعض العلوم لابد تعرفها وتفهمها لكي تفهم القرآن. There are certain things about the Quran that you have to understand, and with that you understand the Quran. Like what? Like هناك قسم. نعم الله يقسم. والقسم لها ثلاثة أركان. نعم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He swears in His book. نعم. And the swearing, it requires a letter. It requires a muqsam bi, the thing that you're swearing by. Wa muqsam alayh, the thing that you're swearing for. نعم. فإنما تقرأ قرآن لابد تنظر لهذا الشيء. When you read Quran, you have to recognize these things. أيضا مما درسنا الأسئلة الاستفهام that has meanings. نعم. فالله سبحانه وتعالى يقول إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر. We sent it down on the night of the decree. وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر. Well, what will make you know what ليلة القدر is? This is a question. نعم. ماذا نستفيد من هذا السؤال يا أبو غني؟ هذا السؤال from Allah. This is a question from Allah. What do we benefit from this question? What does this question convey, Ghalib? ماذا يفيد هذا يا صالح؟ وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر؟ ما تعظيم. تعظيم. Allah wants to magnify this. نعم. He wants to make it important to you. فقال القارعة. القارعة. ما القارعة؟ What is القارعة؟ وما أدراك ما القارعة؟ What will make you know what this قارعة is? هذا من أجل التعظيم. To make it something in a big and exalted with you. So now you're going to really pay attention and understand that this is important. نعم. وأخذنا أسئلة أخرى. هنا الله سبحانه وتعالى أحيانا يأتي سؤال يفيد الإنكار. Or it could يفيد a negation. فمثال نحن قد درسنا هذا. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول هذا السؤال ومن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا. And who's more wrong than the one that tells a lie or fabricates a lie about Allah? It's a question. ومن أظلم من هذا. Who's more wrong than هذا. ماذا يفيد هذا السؤال؟
تكبير يعني الظلم هذا تعظيم.
سمعتم صالحا. ماذا يفيد هذا يوسف؟ ومن أعظم ومن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا. ومن أظلم من هذا. This is a question. لكن ماذا يفيد يا أبو غني؟ الله يبارك فيك طول عمرك أجبت أحسنت. بمعنى النفي. What did this question mean? Who is more wrong than the one who lies on Allah? Meaning nobody is more wrong than him. Who يفيد negation. يفيد النفي. ولكن في على طريق سؤال. It comes in the form of a question. نعم. أحيانا يفيد إنكار. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول هذا قد درسنا أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. أيظن الناس هكذا. أحسب الناس. Does mankind think that we'll be left alone saying we believe and they won't be tested? This is a question. هذا استفهام. لكن ماذا يريد الله? This is a question. What does Allah want from this? إنكار هذا الشيء. This is not going to happen. This is not going to happen. طيب. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول أشرح لدني نعم الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول عفى الله عنك لما أذنت لهم هذا سؤال. May Allah forgive you. Why did you give them permission? Now, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أذن للمنافقين أن يتخلفوا عن الغزو. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gave permission to some of the munafiqeen, the hypocrites, to stay behind and not go out on the expedition. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال عفى الله عنك لما أذنت له. May Allah forgive you. Why did you give them permission? ماذا نستفيد من هذا الاستفهام? What do we benefit from this question? لوم وتوبيخ. This is blame. Allah is blaming him. Allah is blaming him. Like you would say to your son, didn't I tell you not to do that? Didn't I tell you not to go there? It's a question, na'am. Well, like, he's not supposed to say, yes, you did. It's an inkar. هو اللوم يا أبا بلال أنت معي. هذا اللوم. ولكن على جهة ماذا؟ سؤال. طيب الآن يا إخوتي إنما أنت تقرأ قرآن تستنقل من الصالحين ولا الظالمين طيبين ولا الصالحين ولا الظالمين. You don't see any استفهام. ما رأيت أن هذا قسم. ما رأيت أن هذا لا. هذا الذي هو في كتاب الله. أمس أخذنا ماذا؟ أمس أخذنا الذكر والحذف. طيب عندي سؤال. مثلا أقول يا أبا بلال عندي لك قلم. أقول لك عندي لك قلم. I have a new pen for you. Say a pen. You might think it's a pen. I mean, it might be good, might be bad. ممكن هو طيب. يا عندي لك نعال. أقول لك عندي لك نعال. If I could, I have some shoes for you. You're going to be like, ايش من نعال? Are they good shoes? Are they bad shoes? Like, if I said to you, عندي لك شيئا ستفرح به والله. خلاص, أنا طمعتك فيه. If I said to you, I have something for you, والله, you're going to like it. I حذفت, I didn't mention it. I didn't mention what it is. But if I said, I have a pen for you, I have some shoes for you. You're not gonna be like, oh man, you're not, your mind is just gonna be محدد. ذهنك والفرحك سيكون محدد. ممكن هو انه عالم استعمل. Maybe they're used shoes that he had for a long time. Maybe they're new. I don't know. عندي شيء لك والله ستفرح به. I have something for you. والله, you're gonna like it. Now you're like, oh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. ماذا سيعطيك؟ ما ذكره, ما يحتاج. لما قال وسترضى خلاص. نعم. الله سبحانه وتعالى says ولسوف يعطيك ربك. Your Lord is going to give you. وسترضى, you're going to be pleased with it. He didn't even say what he's going to give. حذف, هذا حذف. He didn't mention what he's going to give you. ولكن رغبك فيه. He increased your interest in it by making it unknown. يا عبد الصبور, أنت معي, are you with me? ولسوف يعطيك ربك, and your Lord. سوف means this is توكيد, that he's definitely going to give it to you. ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. You're going to be pleased. What is he going to give you? When Allah says سترضى. طيب يا إخوة, today we want to go back to our surah, surah التكاثر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون. قبل هذا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الهاكم التكاثر. عندك هناك يا إخوة. نعم. ما هذا الهاكم؟ الهاكم التكاثر. ماذا تستفيد من هذا؟ ماذا معنى الهاكم؟ أحسنت. ما اسمك يا كريم؟ سيف. ما شاء الله, حياك الله, أجبت وأسبت. نعم, شغلكم التكاثر. التكاثر بمعنى ليس الواحد يريد كثير. تكاثر doesn't mean somebody just trying to get increase and trying to get more, but he's competing. هذا الذي نستفيد من الألف التكاثر. ما قال ألهاكم الكثرة، ما ألهاكم التكثر، لا، ما قال التكثر، قال التكاثر. This aleph, it conveys that you're competing with one another to try to get more. This shagalatkum, it preoccupied you from what? Allah didn't mention what it preoccupied you from. Allah came in al-akhirah, from the hereafter. Anta'ah. Na'am. Hatta zurtumul maqabir. Until you die. Hatta al-maut. Na'am. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that, he says, kalla sawfa ta'lamun. Hadha wa'id, ya ikhwati billah. Kalla bima'na la yanbaghi lak an tanshaghal. Kalla tariqatuk khata. La yanbaghi lak. Kalla. This is not correct what you're on. You've been preoccupied by chasing worldly affairs and competing. Kalla. Kalla. You feed and have an lion buggy luck. This is not suitable. This is not correct. Sawfa ta'lamun. You're going to know. And have the wa'id. This is a threat from Allah. Walakin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dhakara ba'duhu ba'd. Dhakarahu ba'da al-maqabir. He mentioned it after the grave. Meaning, idha dakhalta qabrak sata'lam hadha al-wa'id. Ba'duhum yaqul hadha. عذاب القبر كلا سوف تعلمون يعني إذا دخلت قبرك ستعلم قضية هذا أنه كان خاطئ أنه كان لا ينبغي لك. You're going to know when you're in your grave. Allah says كلا سوف تعلمون. He mentioned this after he mentioned your grave. In your grave you're going to know how bad it was when you were chasing the dunya. It's going to be in a punishment there. نعم يا يوسف. على عذاب القبر. أحسنت. This ayah يدل على عذاب القبر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says after that, ثم كلا سوف تعلمون. ثم. ما معنى ثم؟ ما معنى ثم؟ يعني ثم يفيد الترتيب مع مهلة. يعني بعد القبر ستعلمون يعني في الآخرة يعني في عذاب الله يعني في النار. نعم. ثم it conveys that something happens in order, but ثم is later on فيما بعد. نعم. على سبيل المثال أنا أقول خرجت من المسجد فذهبت إلى البيت. إذا أقول خرجت من المسجد فذهبت إلى البيت بمعنى مباشر. If I say فذهبت means I, right after the masjid I went to the house. وإذا أقول خرجت من المسجد ثم ذهبت إلى البيت ممكن ذهبت إلى السوق وممكن ذهبت إلى كذا. ثم it conveys that there's a period of time later on. مهلة ترتيب مع مهلة. نعم. So Allah says, ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. And after you're in your graves, you're going to know more later on after that. That being preoccupied with worldly affairs, it's not good. You're going to know later. So first you're going to know in the punishment in the grave. Then you're going to know in the hellfire. In the hellfire. نعم. هذا قول من بعد صلف منهم ابن عباس. نعم. وما معنى كلا؟ الفراء يقول ليس الأمر على ما أنتم عليه من التفاخر. ليس الأمر هكذا. أنتم تظنون أن هذا الذي هو طيب الحاكم التكاثر. كلا لا ينبغي يكون هكذا. هذا معنى كلا means the matter is not the way that you are doing it. This is not correct. This is one of the meanings of كلا in the Quran. كلا is to negate and being opposite of what you're doing. That is not correct. وَبَعْضُمْ يَقُولُ أَنْ هَذَا وَعِيدٌ بَعْدَ وَعِيدٌ. كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ أي سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ عَاقِبَةَ هَذَا. هذا معنى هذا. كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ أي سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ عَاقِبَةَ هَذَا. كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. You're going to know what is the result, what is the final outcome of being preoccupied with worldly affairs? You're going to know. It's a threat. It's a threat. Like if somebody said to you, you're going to see what I'm going to do with you. You're going to see what I'm going to do. Damn, he didn't say what he's going to do. You're going to recognize what I'm going to do to you. You're going to see. It's a threat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yundiruna wa yukhawifuna wa lakin man yakhaf. Allah threatens us. Who feels threatened? Who feels threatened? We read these surahs. Kalla sawfa ta'lamun. Tayyib. Kayfa anna Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala kalla sawfa ya'lamun. Kalla ahwan. They're going to know. Maybe you can take it off yourself. He said, ta'lamun. If Allah said, you know, kalla sawfa ya'lamun, if he said, they are going to know, you might just say, oh, it's not concerning me. It's not concerning me because it's they. But Allah said, ta'lamun, you're going to know. And you're reading the Quran. You're reading the Quran, wa adma'ir muwajjah ilayh. The pronouns are directed to you. You're reading it. Kayfa nakfar. How do we feel that this is not concerning us? It's concerning us. So if the shoe fits, wear it. Hakadha naqul fil inglisi. If the shoe fits, wear it. Yani in kana al asifa munasib lak, huwa lak. If hadhi yantabiq alayk, وانشغلت بالدنيا عن الآخرة فانتبه يا إخوة عندنا إخوة الدنيا شغلته عن الطاعة. Now there's people, Muslims, that chasing the dunya has preoccupied them from the hereafter, meaning so they leave off wajibat and they fall into some muharramat. Right. There's another people الدغه الدنيا شغلتهم عن المستحبات وهم يقيمون الواجبات الحمد لله. There are some people the dunya has just preoccupied them from the mustahab, but as for the wajib, they do it. And there are some people they refuse that their dunya take away from their mustahab. الذي يجي يجي. Whatever comes from the money comes. But I'm going to make sure I do my sunnah prayers. I'm going to make sure I get this. I'm going to make sure I read Quran. I'm going to make sure that I have that. Tayyib. Fi kulli ha'ulai. Out of all these people. There's a group. Shagalatum anil ta'a. Some of them, the dunya took away, preoccupied them from obedience. There's one, dunya decreased from their obedience. Preoccupied them from what? From the mustahabbat. And there's some that the dunya didn't preoccupy them. Tayyib, Adam and Haifa Rizq. Now let's look at their lives. Man is su'ada min ha'ulai. Who are the ones that are happy? Who's the one, him and his wife is mashallah mutahabu, and him and his wife, they love one another. Him and his kids, mashallah, they get along. He's murtah, he's comfortable, whatever comes to it. Does it guarantee that the one shagalatu ad-dunya anil akhir anu murtah? Yeah. Isn't that guaranteed that the one that the dunya preoccupied him from thought, that him and his wife, most likely him and his wife, they're not that good. And him and his kids, they're not that good. And that's the sa'adah will be tawfiq ilah. This happiness and this joy is from Allah. So after all that, what did you actually gain? Let's see who's really, really happy. Him and his wife, Sinwan. Him and his wife, Shmin Mahabba. كل ما يزيد العمر هي تزيد جمالا عند في عيني. In his eyes, she's just more beautiful. She just gets more beautiful every year. His kids, his contentment with his life and his house. This one has a house that's just like, mashallah, it's, you know. This one, his house is, but when he enters his house, when he goes inside, إذا دخل بيته لا تجد إلا راحة وبشاشة. It smiles. Happiness, greetings. Where do you buy this happiness? Can you buy it? You can't buy it. No, you can't buy it. We have to recognize these umurs. Who is really, really happy? Why is yadman as-sa'ada? Why is yadmanu? نعم. وهذا الذي نريد أن نركز في هذه الأمور. الله سبحانه وتعالى بعد هذا he says, انظر قبل هذا, كلا سوف تعلمون, هذا وعيد بعد وعيد. Let's understand. كلا سوف تعلمون, ثم كلا سوف تعلمون, من معانيها سوف تعلمون إذا زرتم القبائر المقابر, عفوا, إذا زرتم القبائر المقابر, عفوا, ستعلمون الوعيد, هذا عذاب القبر. ثم كلا سوف تعلمون, هذا عذاب في نار جهنم. هذا من معانيها. نعم. Because Allah mentioned the qabr first. From the meaning of it is that Allah says, حتى زرتم المقابر, until you visited the graves, you've been preoccupied. كلا, you're going to know. Meaning, if you enter the graves, you're going to know. ثم كلا سوف تعلمون, meaning later on, after the grave in hellfire, you're going to know again. So this is from the meaning of كلا سوف تعلمون, ثم كلا سوف تعلمون. That's from the meaning. Other than say هو وعيد بعد وعيد. It's a threat after a threat. Just in general, it's a threat after a threat. Ibn Jarir al-Tabri يقول ثم كلا سوف تعلمون يقول ما هكذا ينبغي أن تفعلوا أن يلهيكم التكاثر بالأموال وكثرة العدد سوف تعلمون لا ينبغي أن تفعلوا هذا. هذا معنى كلا. This is not suitable for you to be preoccupied by dunya. That's what كلا means. This لا ينبغي لا كلا. That's what كلا means. This is not suitable. You should not do that. This is what كلا means. Right? After this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين. قال لو علمتم حق اليقين لما ألحاكم التكاثر عن طلب الدار الآخرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, nay. If you all knew علم اليقين, if you all knew and had knowledge of that knowledge of certainty, you would have never been preoccupied with the dunya. I mean, this has to do with a lack of knowledge and a lack of yaqeen and iman. This is why you got preoccupied with the dunya. هذا سبب انشغالكم بالآخرة قلة اليقين وقلة العلم. كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين ما شغلتكم التكاثر. If you are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين, and the rest of it is محذوف. كلا, if you knew علم اليقين, the knowledge of certainty, you would have never been preoccupied with the dunya over the hereafter. But it's as if you have some shock. Like you have some shock. No, if I work hard, even if I leave off some of the salah and I leave off some of the thing, main thing, I get that money. That's what you're thinking. You're not doing it unawarely. You're aware. Maka law tarakt juma wa tarakt ba'd juma wa lakin ajma min huna wa ajma min lalli. Ajma fa ma'da. Na'am. It's like if I leave off juma this week and leave off that juma, maybe I might get enough money to, ajma hada haram ya akhi. Kayf? Na'am. What made you start thinking like that? Na'am. لو تعلمون علم اليقين لما ألهاكم التكاثر. If you had strong certain knowledge, you would have never been preoccupied on the ta'a. So preoccupied doesn't mean just that you're busy. هذا يقع, that you're busy. But it's not going to preoccupy on what? On the ta'a. هذا معنى هذه الآيات. بالمناسبة نقرأ حديث عظيم في صحيح البخاري عن أبي هريرة. أنتم تعرفون هذا حديث أعظمكم أكثركم وحديث عظيم. هو في البخاري ولعله في مسلم أيضا عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لله ملائكة يطوفون في الطرق يلتمسون أهل الذكر. Verily for Allah is malaika. He has angels, yatufuna fi turuq. They go around in their ways that they go around, looking for the people of dhikr. They are flying around looking in the masjids of the people that remember Allah. فَإِذَا وَجَدُوا قَوْمًا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ تَنَادَوْا حَلُمُّوا إِلَىٰ حَاجَتِكُمْ. If they found some people remembering Allah, they call out, come over here. إِلَىٰ حَاجَتِكُمْ. You need the thing that you're looking for is over here. فَيَحُفُّونَهُمْ بِأَجْنِحَتِهِمْ إِلَىٰ سَمَاءُ الدُّنْيَا. So they surround these people with their wings all the way up to the sky. And this surrounding is protection. They surround these people with their wings all the way up to the sky. فَيَسْأَلُهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ وَهُوَ أَعْلَمْ مِنْهُمْ. So their Lord, Allah asks the malaika, he asks them some questions, and Allah already knows the answer. ماذا يقول عبادي? What are my servants saying while they're in the masjid there? يقولون يسبحونك. They're saying subhanallah, ويكبرونك. Where they're saying Allahu Akbar, ويحمدونك. And they're praising you, saying alhamdulillah, ويمجدونك. They're praising you. قال فيقول هل رأوني? Allah asked him, did they see me? قالوا لا والله ما رأوك. The malaika say, لا, by Allah, they've never saw you. فيقول كيف لا رأوني? Allah says, how would it be if they saw me? وَأَنَّ مَلَائِكَهُمْ أَنفُسُهُمْ مَا رَأَوْا اللَّهَ. The malaika themselves, مَا رَأَوْا اللَّهَ. The malaika themselves, they haven't seen Allah. يَقُولُونَ لَوْ رَأَوْكَ كَانُوا أَشَدُّ لَكَ عِبَادَةً وَأَشَدُّ لَكَ تَمْجِيدًا وَتَحْمِيدًا وَأَكْثَرَ لَكَ تَسْبِيحًا. They said, if they would have seen you, if they seen you, they would be more eager in their ibadah. They would have more ibadah. وَأَشَدُّ لَكَ تَمْجِيدًا وَتَمْحِيدًا وَتَحْمِيدًا. They would praise you more and speak more of you more. وَتَسْبِيحًا. And they would take all the faults and anything mistakes away from you. They would just accredit the mistakes to themselves. And the mistakes in the court chums, that's on me. I'm Allah. Allah didn't wrong me any. فَيَقُولُ فَمَاذَا يَسْأَلُونِي. What are you asking me for? قال يسألونك الجنة. So they're asking you for Jannah. فيقول هل رأوها? Did they see it? قالوا لا والله ما رأوها. They said by Allah, they haven't seen it. فيقول كيف لو رأوا كيف أنهم كيف لو أنهم رأوها? What if they have seen it? يقولون لو أنهم رأوها كانوا أشد عليها حرصا وأشد لها طلبا وأعظم فيها رغبة. If they saw it, they would have more hurts, more zealousness for it, if they would saw it. Well, I can do it with iman, ya ikhwa, it's on faith. It's just based on faith. حسب ما قرأنا. According to what we read, according to what we believe. لو أنهم رأوها, if they would have seen it, كانوا أشدوا عليها حرصا. They would have more zealousness for it. وأشدوا لها طلبا. They would request it more. وَأَعْظَمُ فِيهَا رَغْبًا. Their desire for it would be greater if they had seen it. قَالَ فَمِمَّا يَتَعْوَذُونَ. What are they seeking refuge from? What are they seeking protection from and shelter from? يَقُولُونَ مِنَ النَّارِ. So they're seeking protection from the hellfire. فَيَقُولْ هَلْ رَأَوْهَا? Did they see it? قَالُوا لَا وَاللَّهِ يَا رَبِّي مَا رَأَوْهَا. They say, we swear by Allah, oh my Lord, they haven't seen it. قال يقول فكيف لو رأوها? What if they had seen the hellfire? يقولون لو رأوها كانوا أشد منها فرارا وأشد لها مخافة. If they have seen it, they would be more, they would flee from it more. They would be fleeing from it more. وَشَدُّ لَهَا مَخَافَةً. They would fear it more. فَيَقُولْ أُشْهِدُكُمْ أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. Allah says to Malaika, I bring you all to witness that I have forgiven them. And these people that come out to the masjid and they remember Allah, I bring you all to witness that I have forgiven them. يَقُولُ مَلَكٌ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَ فِيهِمْ فُلَانٌ ليس منهم إنما جاء لي حاجة. When the malaika say, Ya Allah, amongst them is this person over there. He's not from them that's memorizing and making dhikr. He just came to the masjid for a personal need. He's not with them. قال إنهم الجلساء لا يشقى بهم جليسهم. They are all the ones sitting and memorizing Allah. No one who's amongst them is going to be disappointed. I mean, he's going to get his reward too. Man. فَهَذَا ذِكْرٌ نَّا. Even the one that's here, maybe he's in the back. Maybe he's reading the book on something else. He's not paying attention to the dhas. وَكَنُوا أَحْسَنَ أَنْ يَكُنْ خَارِجٌ. He might be in the back. He might be reading the book. He might not be paying attention. But it's better than he be outside. نعم. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال عيش الحديث أريد أما اجتمع قوم في بيت من بيوت الله. No people gather up in the house from the houses of Allah. يتلون كتاب الله ويتدارسونه بينهم. They're reciting the book of Allah. ويتدارسونه بينهم. ماذا يفيد هذا الألف؟ من يجيب؟ Allah says they're reciting the book amongst themselves. ويتدارسون. He didn't say يدرسون, that they're studying. يتدارسون. What is this ألف؟ المشاركة. أنا أقرأ عند صالح وهذا يقرأ عند فلان وشوقي عند عبد الصبور. It's musharaka. Everyone's not in the corner by themselves. Now let's say istimrar. Al-musharaka. That they're cooperating together. وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ فِي مَا بَيْنَهُمْ. No people do that. إِلَّا نَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهُمْ السَّكِينَ. Sakina comes down upon them. Ash has a sakina. Al-Hu Kalam Fadi. Is this a name? It's just called Sakina. Tranquility comes on up. No, these are people that find the raha. Go out in the street and see the problems that you have out there. You got bills, you got debt, you got this. Come to the masjid and see how you feel when you hear the book of Allah. Satartah. Anta shahid ala nafsik. You're a witness on your own self. Hada ma'na Sakina. Don't get the Sakina is something white that's going to come down, it's going to be on top of you. La anta sataskun. You're going to be comfortable. Satansa ad-dunya. Kani Sheikh Makbur rahimahullah. كان يقول إذا قل حدثنا وأخبرنا نسيت الدنيا كلها. نعم. أو في هذا المعنى رحمه الله. كان الشيخ مكبر يقول If I say حدثنا, I'm reading the books of hadith. If I say حدثنا, reading the chain, I forgot all the problems of the dunya. When I open up that book and I'm in the dust, I forgot everything. ونحن في أمس الحاجة إلى هذا. We need حتى نعالج أنفسنا من تعب الدنيا. الدنيا تعب يا أخي. هذا الزمن الذي نحن فيه أولادنا يعانون من يعني أشغال, من ضيق النفس, من anxiety, من الضيق. كان من الأنزاي الضيق كان يأتي إلى الكبير. Our children suffer from anxiety. Anxiety was somebody that was 60 years old. 50 years old, maybe get some anxiety. الشباب في هذا الزمن هم أمران نفساني. They have أمور, they have غلق. عندهم مشاكل. ما كان يشيب أحدهم. Maybe they turn gray hair. And they're شباب. Some of them are 20 years old thinking about suicide. They think about killing themselves. شباب ضيعوا ما يتوقعون أن يعيش بعد 20 عام. Some of them, these disbelievers, they don't expect after 20 years, 25 years, they don't even think they'll still be alive. وين هذا؟ يعني في حاجة إلى السكينة. هذا السكينة محله في بيت الله. نعم. هذا حقيقة. نعم. إلا نزلت عليهم السكينة وغشيتهم الرحمة. The mercy of Allah covers them. وحفتهم الملائكة. And the ملائكة, they surround them. وذكرهم الله في من عنده. And Allah mentions them to those that are in the sky. Mention them by their name. Fulan, 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 Fulan. Allah mentions them. فمن بطأت به عمله لم يسرع به نسبه يا سبحان الله للمسكين فيصله أن يتنافس من بطأت به عمله whoever his deeds has slowed him down and he has a little bit of deeds his deeds has slowed him down لم يسرع به نسبه his affiliation and his family and whoever he is affiliated to that's not going to speed him up that he's Fulan and Amriki I'm the Amriki That's not gonna, I'm from Beit Fulan. I'm from this family. That's not gonna help you none. If your diesel slowed you down, whoever you affiliate to, I'm down with these people. I know these people. I know that tajir. That's not gonna help you none. طيب هذا درسنا اليوم هذه دروس فيها خير. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يحفظنا جميعا وأن يريحنا جميعا ويزيدنا علما وعملا حفظا وفهما. إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم